That's it. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax.
People misunderstand it in a lot of ways. People think that you're just sitting down in a car, and they're not just sitting down in the car. You got G-force, you're making crazy bank turns. When you're in a car for 2 hours, it gets crazy intense.
The first place I really realized how punishing driving was on your body is in my first couple of little 50-lap races out at our local short track in the super late model division.
Well, when I first met Spencer and we started going through and went through the assessment, and I was blown away in a negative way.
Frankly, it was a little bit of a butterball. And, you know, you don't get out of these cars after a couple of hundred laps if you're not in shape.
You know, the hand walks that we were doing earlier, for example, to have him start out with those, I mean, he was taking two steps up and then having to walk back out. You getting fired up about Phoenix, dude, or what?
I'm kidding, I'm pumped.
You fired up about that?
Oh, yeah.
Are you
oh,
sure?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, what's exciting about Phoenix for you?
What ain't, hell.
Yeah.
And get to our first race off.
It's a big
dog. It's gonna be a bigger track. It's a whole mile track. I thought Irwindale was big. My God, this thing's gonna be huge.
Yeah.
And you gotta really be able to keep your body straight, you know, keep your body from breaking down, but more importantly, keep your mental focus up, you know, be able to be there at that 500th lap, be making smart choices, you know, be making that pass. And the guys that don't, they're the guys that fade off and, you know, ultimately end up getting, you know, wrecked or fall way back during the end of the race. You got to be on your game when those last 10 laps come. That's where all the real racing gets done, is, you know, the last 50, 10 laps.
Quiet your upper body just a little bit through the center and relax. Atta, baby. That's a wrap outside, buddy.